Hello viewers, so today we will discuss some important points regarding types of electronic transitions, and these types of electronic transitions comes under UV visible spectroscopy. And if you are directly watching this video, you just kindly refer to my previous videos. So those are the UV visible spectra related YouTube videos. Where you can find how the electromagnetic radiation interacts with matter, and what are the different types of molecular energy levels are there, and what are the selection rules for UV visible transitions. So in this video we will discuss about the different types of electronic transitions which are possible to appear in UV visible spectrum or electronic spectra of a compound. See, we have seen the organic molecule generally will have three types of electrons: sigma electrons, that means sigma bonds, pi electrons or pi bonds, and n electrons are non-bonding electrons. That means on some of the atoms like oxygen, nitrogen and halogens, you will find a lone pair of electrons, one or two or three. So the transitions are nothing but moving of electrons from one energy level to the other electronic energy level. So the types of molecular orbitals which are available to us, as we discussed earlier in our videos, are sigma, sigma star, pi, pi star, and non-bonding electrons. Whenever the molecules absorb this UV visible radiation, the electrons move from one lower energetic energy level to the higher energetic energy level. So for example, the movement also may be in reverse direction. That means whenever the molecule returns from higher energy level to the lower energy level, from high to low, then it releases the energy in the form of light or maybe in the form of heat. So the thing is here, transitions are nothing but movement of electrons from one place, one orbital to the other energy orbital, and there are the various types of molecular orbitals available according to their energy, if we can say the sigma, pi, then n, then pi star, and sigma star. So these are the various orbitals. Then so when they absorb the energy, it moves from one place to the other place, one orbital to the other higher energetic orbital. And whenever the molecule moves from higher to lower, then it releases the energy while it is returning back. So this is how the absorption takes place. Then see here in this slide, we can clearly see the different types of possible transitions which are theoretically possible. So from sigma to sigma star is one thing, another arrow is from sigma to pi star, and third arrow is from left to right, it is from pi to pi star, and then there is one from pi to sigma star, and there is one from n to sigma star, and so other one is sigma to pi star is also there. So there are the six possible transitions, and we are considering the starting points are sigma, pi and n. So the starting points are, the starting points are sigma, pi and n in the upward transition, and the destinations are maybe pi star or sigma star. So these are the theoretically possible transitions: sigma to sigma star, sigma to pi star, pi to sigma star, pi to pi star, n to pi star, n to sigma star. So these are the various possible transitions. Out of these possible transitions, we will discuss which type of energy is required for these transitions, and actually in a UV visible spectrum, what type of these transitions will appear for us. So these things we will discuss now. First, we will look at the sigma to sigma star transitions. Sigma to sigma star transitions arises when the electrons move from sigma bonding orbital to the sigma antibonding molecular orbital. So we have seen already in LCFO combination method. So whenever there is a sigma bond, there are two orbitals, molecular orbitals. One is sigma and another one is sigma star. For these transitions to happen, the energy required is a larger energy. Means more energy is required for these transitions to take place. More energy means smaller wavelength. That means, as already we discussed, so E is equal to h nu or E is equal to hc by lambda. So according to that energy equation, energy is inversely proportional to the wavelength. So therefore, whenever there is higher energy, that means it is lower wavelength. So therefore, for these transitions to happen, or these transitions will happen at smaller wavelengths, because the energy required is large here. For example, if you take methane, methane is the molecule which is having all the sigma bonds only, because the formula of methane is CH4, and all there will be four sigma bonds between the carbon and hydrogens. So this molecule is, because it's having only the sigma bonds, the electrons will move from sigma to sigma star. For these transitions to occur, we need a wavelength of light 125 nanometers. And for similarly for ethane, where the formula is C2H6, the transition happen at 135 nanometers. And being this energy means wavelength 125, 135 nanometers, this is not in our range of UV visible light, because as we discussed, UV visible light wavelength range is from 200 to 800 nanometers. So this is out of that range, because this is less than 200 nanometers. So therefore, this is not useful for our electronic spectra. Then second type of transitions are N2 sigma star. N means non-bonding or lone pair of electrons. So which are moving to the sigma star molecular orbital. Here also the energy required is a very, you know, higher energy. That means approximately it will be in the range of 150 to 250 nanometers. And the compounds which undergo these transitions are the compounds which are having only sigma bonds, and also another condition is there should be a heteroatom. Heteroatom means the atom which is having a lone pair of electrons. Maybe, for example, nitrogen, one lone pair, oxygen, two lone pair of electrons, and halogen, there will be three lone pair of electrons on them. So therefore, those are here, these type of transitions will happen when there are two conditions are satisfied. One, the molecule should be with only sigma bonds, and another condition is the heteroatom should be there, because there should be n electrons. N electrons are possible only when there are oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur or halogens are present, then only n electrons will be there. So for example, if you consider methyl alcohol, the formula is CH3OH. It is having all the sigma bonds and it is having oxygen. Oxygen will have a lone pair of two lone pair of electrons on it. Therefore, this is methyl alcohol. And ethyl chloride, that is C2H5Cl. Here also all the sigma bonds are there and one halogen is there. Therefore, n electrons are there. So these type of molecules which are saturated. Saturated means which are having all sigma bonds only, no pi bonds. So saturated compounds which are having oxygen, nitrogen or halogen, these compounds will show N2 sigma star transitions, and these are also not very much useful for our UV visible spectra. Why? Because the energy required is larger, and mostly it is out of the range of UV visible, because it's 150 to 250. So these transitions are also not very much useful for us. And another thing why we won't consider these transitions is these are the forbidden transitions. Forbidden transitions means, as we discussed in our earlier videos, there will be selection rules, spin selection rule will be there, symmetry selection rule will be there. So according to the symmetry selection rule, so the transition should be from G to U or U to G. This condition cannot be applied here because N is not having any symmetry, N orbital. So therefore, these are the forbidden transitions according to the selection rules. As we discussed, forbidden transitions never gives more intense bands because the probability of transitions will be very, very less for them. So therefore, less number of organic compounds show these transitions because there should be saturation, there should be the more oxygen or heteroatoms should be there. So these are the conditions. So therefore, less number of organic compounds show these type of transitions. And the third and fourth, these are also not very useful for our UV visible spectra because these are also higher energetic and they won't follow the selection rules. So see, sigma to pi star and pi to sigma star. Sigma to pi star and pi to sigma star transitions, these are absolutely forbidden transitions according to the symmetry or Laporte selection rule. Because sigma to pi star is nothing but G to G and pi to sigma star is nothing but U to U. And moreover, these are the energy gap between sigma and pi star and pi and sigma star orbitals is larger. So therefore, energy required for these transitions is higher. Therefore, these are also not very much useful for our UV visible spectra. Then we will go to the two other important transitions, types of transitions, which are very much useful for UV visible spectra, without which the UV visible spectra may not be exist. For example, if we take pi to pi star transitions, these are very much useful for electronic spectra, and the energy required for these transitions is well within the range of 200 to 700 nanometers. That means the energy required for these transitions to happen, or the energy required for these transitions, is within the range of UV visible light. That means if you apply UV visible light, these transitions will take place. And these transitions, pi to pi star transitions, are allowed according to the selection rules. According to the selection rules, so symmetry selection rule, we have seen there should be change in parity. That means maybe U to G or G to U. If we consider the center of symmetry of this pi and pi star, and pi orbital is U, pi star is G, therefore pi to pi star is nothing but it is U to G. This is a symmetry allowed transition. And so therefore these are well within the range of UV visible radiation, and these are the allowed transitions according to the selection rules. So therefore these are very much useful for our UV visible spectra. And generally these transitions need an unsaturated group in the molecule. Unsaturated group means there must be pi bonds or pi electrons should be there. So for example, alkenes, C double bond C. Alkynes, C triple bond C. Carbonyl compounds, C double bond O. And aromatic compounds. Aromatic compounds also will have unsaturation. So maybe for example, benzene ring, C6H6. So we will write three pi bonds in a ring. So like that, those compounds which are having unsaturation will undergo pi to pi star transitions. And here there is another new word called molar absorptivity. Molar absorptivity, it is denoted by the symbol called epsilon. See, just wait. So this molar absorptivity is denoted by a symbol called epsilon. So this epsilon indicates the probability. If more epsilon, the transition probability will be more. That means more number of transitions will take place and the signal will appear with a good intensity. So intensity of the signal or transition probability of a transition will be denoted by its epsilon value. If larger epsilon value is there, that means it is more intense, peak will come from it. And these are the highly probable transitions, means more probability will be there for these transitions to take place. So like this, these pi to pi star transitions, see, these pi to pi star transitions, you know, yes, are very much useful for our UV visible spectra. And other type of transitions are N2 pi star transitions. These N2 pi star transitions are also very much useful for the electronic spectra or UV visible spectra, because the energy required for these N2 pi star transitions is within the range of UV visible light, that is 200 to 800 nanometers. And for these transitions to happen, not only pi electrons, there should be N electrons also. So N means non-bonding electrons or lone pair of electrons must be present there, and pi bonds also must be present there. So these transitions require an unsaturated group and an atom with lone pair of electrons. Unsaturated group provides you pi bonds, that means pi and pi star orbitals, and the non-bonding electrons on hetero atoms provides you the N electrons or N orbitals. So these are well within the range of UV visible light, it's good, but the second condition is these are not symmetry allowed transitions. That means according to selection rules, these are the forbidden transitions. So therefore, its epsilon values are very smaller number, to 10 to 100, and that is m centimeter is nothing but the, these are the units of these are the units of epsilon per we can write molarity, no? So like this, molarity and centimeter per molar per centimeter, we can say like this. So those are the units of epsilon, and these are only, see, these are only 10 to 100, the value of epsilon is only of 10 to 100. So whereas in the previous slide we have seen the epsilon value is 1000 to 10,000, so last but one line, 1000 to 10,000 epsilon value. So therefore pi to pi star transitions are more probable transitions, they appear with more intensity. And in the final slide, we can see how these pi to pi star and N to pi star transition intensities will be. So these are less intense transitions, less probable transitions, N to pi star, and the epsilon values are very small. And as we discussed, the compound should be with unsaturation, and there should be a heteroatom like oxygen or nitrogen or a halogen. So therefore the carbonyl compounds, C double bond O, nitro compounds, NO2 group, and alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compounds. That means C double bond O must be there. You know, adjacent to the C double bond O group, the carbon is called as alpha carbon. And, you know, so adjacent to alpha carbon is beta carbon. So alpha beta position, if you are having double bond, that is alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound. So these type of compounds will show the N2 pi star transitions. See, in this picture we can see the different types of transitions and the required energy, and sigma to sigma star. So if you see the sigma to sigma star, so these are 102, these are 102 200 here. So therefore they are out of the range of these things, and N2 sigma star are also somewhat, you know, outer region. This pi 2 pi star, and these are the pi 2 pi star, different types of pi 2 pi star, and these are the N2 pi star. So these are within the range of this 200 to 700 or 800 nanometers. So therefore we can see here the different transitions and the energy required. So alkanes, sigma to sigma star, and the compounds having oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur, halogens, so those are N2 sigma star, and pi 2 pi star, isolated pi bond. Isolated means which is far away, which is singly existed, and diens means having two double bonds, and conjugated pi bonds. Conjugated pi bonds means the compounds which are having double bonds in alternate positions. And N2 pi star means, as we discussed. So these are the energy requirements And for pi to pi star and n to pi star transitions, the energy required is well within the range of this UV visible light. So therefore, they are very much useful in our study of UV visible spectra. So here, see the example here, we are watching the UV visible spectra of acetone. So acetone, here formula of acetone is CH3, C double bond OCH3. Here oxygen is having two lone pair of electrons. These are non-bonding electrons. And there is a pi bond between carbon and oxygen. So therefore pi orbitals and pi star orbitals are also present. So the pi electrons and its excited state is pi star. And pi to pi star transition is the one here. Pi to pi star transition here. So this pi to pi star transition is taking place around some 190, something like this. So this pi to pi star transition is with more probability. More probability means more absorbance is there. So more absorbance, that means it's a nice peak. The height of the peak will tell you the intensity of the peak. If more transitions are happening there, then there will be more intensity for that transition, or the peak will appear with a clear, clear, we can easily observe that peak clearly. And there is another one, n2 pi star here. So this n2 pi star is the height of this peak is very less, because as we know, the n2 pi star transitions are less probable transitions, because those are symmetry forbidden transitions. So therefore the peak height or the intensity of the peak is very less here. So we can see clearly the pi to pi star and n to pi star transitions of this acetone molecule in its UV visible spectrum. So next slide, just we will again once we will visit this acetone spectrum. So here we can see lambda max is 195 for pi to pi star transition of acetone, which is having more intensity, which is allowed transition. For n to pi star transition, lambda max is 274. So this is also within the range of UV visible light, but the intensity of the peak is less, or height of the peak is less. So therefore, it is appearing as a small peak. So in this way, we can have a look at these things again. So the types of electronic transitions, or maybe theoretically possible transitions, are sigma to sigma star, sigma to pi star. Out of these things, pi to pi star and n to pi star, pi to pi star and n to pi star transitions are very much useful for UV visible spectra. Sigma to sigma star transitions require more energy, so therefore they will be given by only alkane type of molecules which are having only sigma bonds. These are not useful. N2 sigma star also not useful for us, because the energy required is more than UV visible light. And sigma 2 pi star, pi 2 sigma star are forbidden transitions. Their energy required is high, therefore they are not useful. The useful things are pi 2 pi star transitions. And these pi 2 pi star transitions appear with good intensity because they are satisfying two conditions. One is the energy required for these pi 2 pi star transitions is within the range of UV visible light, and these are the symmetry allowed transitions. Therefore, epsilon values will be more higher in number, higher values, epsilon values will be higher. So therefore, they will appear with good intensity. And n2 pi star transitions, n2 pi star transitions, maybe they are having the energy between 200 to 800 nanometers only, but they are forbidden transitions according to the selection rules. So therefore, they will appear in the UV visible spectrum, but with less intensity, and therefore their epsilon values are very smaller numbers. So here we can see the different types of molecules where they will within the where the energy range will be for them to electronic transitions. And here we are discussed one example, acetone. Here pi to pi star and n to pi star transitions, and what are their lambda max value? Lambda max value is nothing but the wavelength at which the maximum absorption is occurring, or maximum transitions are taking place. So here the pi to pi star transition is having higher intensity and N2 pi star transition is having lower intensity. So these are the points, some of the points regarding these electronic transitions, types of electronic transitions. And this topic is particularly useful for BSc chemistry students for their semester exams. And if you want more clarity on this topic, please watch my previous videos. As already told you, the interaction, how the electromagnetic radiation interacts with molecules and what are the different types of molecular orbitals, what are the selection rules, all these things. And please subscribe to my YouTube channel. So if you like my video, give a like, and you subscribe to my YouTube channel, where you will find these type of videos. And stay safe. Thank you.